Here pancreas secrete pancreatic juice. This pancreatic juice contains a lot of enzyme. One of the main enzyme is we already see that insulin. It will regulate the blood sugar level. When the concentration of the insulin is less, it means that in our blood the level of the sugar is going to increase, and such condition is called diabetes. And such person who is suffering from this type of the anomaly is called diabetic patient. In diabetic patient, insulin is supplied in the form of the syringe needle. With the help of the needle, they are supplied to their body so that the normal level of the blood sugar will be restored in their body. Now this is the one form. This contains various type of the enzyme. We know that the enzyme are biocatalyst. Enzyme are also called biocatalyst. What is catalyst? Bio means living or life. Living catalyst. Catalyst are a chemical entity which will increase or decrease rate of reaction. Anything which is converting into the other form is reached in a very less time or take more time with the action of these enzymes. That's why they are living. That's why they are called biocatalysts. They are present in our body, generated inside our living organism. So it will break down complex food into the simpler food molecule. Simply, the major constituent of the food, carbohydrate, is digested with the help of the amylase. First, carbohydrate, which is a polysaccharide, is converted into the disaccharide, maltose and the galactose, other form glucose and lactose. Then they are converted into again glucose. This is continuous process. This conversion taking place simultaneously. This is happening around when this digestion taking place. Similarly, protein is made up of amino acids. So these protein are pepsin and trypsin. Pepsin in the stomach and trypsin in the small intestine will break down peptide bonds which connect the amino acid together, will break down by the trypsin and pepsin to convert it into the amino acid, and before that they are converted into peptones, and these peptones again breaking down to convert into the amino acid to release the energy, to give the energy. This is the energy generating process. Here energy is released, here energy is released, and the third one is lipid and fat will again convert it into the simpler constituent fatty acid and glycerol. Fatty acid and glycerol are the simpler thing, which is facilitated by the lipase. Lipase will act onto the lipid and fat. They are converted into the simpler molecule fatty acid and glycerol to give the energy. This is the exothermic process. Digestion is the exothermic process. Overall digestion is not an exothermic, but here this reaction with the exothermic. Here, this process in which the heat is released is the exothermic. But overall digestion needs a energy. So, we cannot say that this statement is wrong. The digestion is the exothermic process. Respiration is the exothermic process, which is the true. But digestion is not an exothermic process, as a overall. But here, carbohydrate is acted by the amylase, converted into the simpler molecule like glucose, and breaking down of glucose will release the energy in the process of respiration. That's why respiration is an exothermic process. So here, a small intestine, food enter into the small intestine. When they are mixed with the bile when they are mixed with the pancreatic juice. Here a small intestine also produces a juice that is called intestinal juice. That intestinal juice, another name that is sacus entericus, is also another name of this juice. This juice is also called sacus entericus. Sacus entericus is the other name of intestinal juice. This intestinal juice contains three types of the enzyme: amylase, lipase, trypsin. We know that the amylase act on the digestion of carbohydrate. Similarly, lipase act on the digestion of lipid and fat, and trypsin act on the digestion of the similar thing, that is called protein. Here substrate is protein. So these are the complete digestion taking place inside the small intestine. In a small intestine, all the digestive process will complete. In a small intestine, finger-like projection is present. That finger-like projection is called villi. Villi. Finger-like projection of a small intestine is villi. This will facilitate absorption. What is absorption? Absorption is a process in which we know that digestion. Digestion is the conversion of complex food molecule into the simpler food molecule. And that simpler food molecule is reabsorbed by the microvilli and reaches to the blood. Reaches to the blood. And the reaching of the blood with the help of the microvilli by the process of simple diffusion or osmosis is called absorption. Absorption is the process of undigested food, digested food, which is in the simpler form, will convert it into the other form. And that thing, that digested thing, is taken or reaches into the blood by the process of the diffusion or osmosis, which technically we should use the term osmosis, and in the simpler form we can use the term diffusion. The intermixing of the particles from the higher concentration to the lower concentration is called diffusion. But when this diffusion taking place in presence of the semi-permeable membrane, the technicality at that case we should use the term osmosis. Osmosis is a better term, that villi will transfer the digested food into the blood stream. In blood, with the help of the blood, they will transfer that thing to the all part of the body, to all organ of the body, to all cell of the body, and the process of transfer of the nutrient digested food to all part of the body for the their fulfilling the energy need is called transportation. Here transportation. Ingestion, the taking of the food inside the mouth is called ingestion. Digestion, the process of conversion of complex food material into the simpler food form with the help of the digestive enzyme is called digestion. And that digested food are reaching to the blood and all part of the body via simply this digested food is entering into the blood, mixing into the blood with the help of the villi is called absorption. And when they reach it to the blood, they will transfer from one part to all part of the body, and that for that we technical term use transportation. The process of the reaching of the nutrient to all part of the body with the help of the blood and the other lymph is called transportation. After doing digested food is reaches to each and every organ, what will happen? We know that respiration is a process by which the digested food molecule is further breaking down into the simpler molecules CO2 and H2O to release the energy. Such a process is called, in presence of the oxygen, is called digestion. So via the digestion, the respiration, that fulfill the energy need of the each and every cell of the body. The process of the utilization of the digested food to give the energy need of the cell and the organ is called assimilation. What is assimilation? When digested food is breaking down into the simpler form to give the energy, to fulfill their energy need, is called assimilation. Clear it? And after that, assimilation. The undigested food, it is all about the digested food. Where the residual food, that is undigested food, it passes to the large intestine. In large intestine, the reabsorption of the water from that undigested food is ensured here. And that undigested food is converted into the solid form. That is called solid waste. And that solid waste is stored in rectum. That solid waste is stored into the rectum. Rectum is an organ which is a temporary storehouse. Temporary storehouse. It stores waste temporarily. And after that, they are attached to the anus. They are attached to the anus. Anus is the opening outside the body at the end of the rectum. In the class 9, we studied that the elementary canal is complete when it starts with the mouth and ends with the anus. So it is a complete elementary canal. In anus, via anus, that undigested food waste product is transferred from your body. And the process of the transfer of the waste from our body is called egestion. Here, excretion or egestion. The process of transfer of the waste from our body to outside is called egestion. The simply digestion concluded in these terms. These are the common terms which is linked to the this chapter. This is the basics of this chapter.